Hello YouTube, today at powerjackrepair.org we got the Dell Inspiron 15, 3000 Inspiron 3582, says right there on the bottom, P75F, P75F 007. There's a whole bunch of Dell Inspirons 15, so if this is not exactly your model, then you might want to look at our channel, we got a whole bunch of them. Alright, so today we're gonna try and fix the connector right here. So the first thing is we basically unscrew everything on the bottom. I guess somebody already tried to unscrew it before. Obviously another screw right there. Come on. Let's try and see if we can get this guy out of here. Come on. Come on. Let's try this guy. Okay. Good job. Ay-yay-yay, somebody over-torqued the screws. So it's not even possible to unscrew it. Right guys, this is not a lug nuts on your car, on your wheel. Yeah. So, I'm not the strongest guy alive to do much about it. So all right, let's break the shell right here. For that we're gonna use this huge guitar pick. All right, so let's not display the client's information. All right, so just guide this guy. Like that. Good job. Let's disconnect the battery first thing, because we don't want anything to get shorted while we are working on the jack, which is right here. Now we're just gonna remove. All right, so we're gonna remove the hinge. Oh, that's too far away. Here, let's try and zoom it in a little bit. All right, let's change the focus. All right, so I changed the focus. Let's open up the whole casing so that the hinge would slightly lift up like that. And you're gonna disconnect this guy, unplug this guy from right here, like that, and like that. Alrighty, so the goal here is there are three cables, basically there's more than three cables, but some of them are joined. There is basically red cables, white, and a couple of black cables. And you can see the pins are crisscrossed, that means that the jack is obviously broken. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna desolder the connectors from the back of this jack and solder them to the new jack. Let me go find the new jacks. Alrighty. So what I'm gonna do is try and get this
Cables desoldered, which is not that easy. So we're gonna add some solder there. So we're gonna remove that. Now I need to figure out which is the plus here, which is the minus. Come on. What I want to do is I want to put those cables through that hole. For that, we need to use those pliers right here and kind of squish the head a little bit. All right. Squish it a bit more. Still doesn't want to go through. Come on. Let's go through. Come on. Let's try to solder it right away as soon as we're gonna put it through. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on. Yeah, like that. All right. Looks good. Let's try and see, maybe we're gonna be able to put the red wire through the same way as we did the black wire. Okay. Uh-oh. The solder got stuck in the pinhole. Here we're gonna warm it up, and hopefully we're gonna be able to push through the wire to the other side. Okay, like that. Yeah, it straightened out. Okay, like that. Good job. Good job. You see how well everything soldered through? It's really important for those wires to be soldered in perfectly. And you see that pin right there, right here is broken, right? That black circle pin is broken. And the new jack has the pin inside. Alrighty, let's bring in the whole thing here. Now let's connect the, you know what, I want to just double check to make sure that the plus is plus, minus is minus, before we're gonna connect anything to anywhere. All right, so this one is gonna be plus, right here. Yep, and this one gonna be data, and this one gonna be minus. Yep, okay. Well, we can also test it on the board when it's connected, like that. Flip this guy over. Okay, I see that the metal bracket might be touching the rear white cable. Right, like that. And let's now like that. Good job. Let's screw this guy in. Yeah, I just want to make sure that white cable isn't shorting. So the goal here is to put some hot glue in the back so that the whole thing wouldn't move and wouldn't push through. In theory, it shouldn't push through because there is some sort of metal bracket in the back there. But in order to insulate the black and red and white wires, we have to put some hot glue
right there. But before we're gonna do that, I wanna just double check again to make sure. Minus is fine. Data signal is fine. And plus is fine. Okay, that looks good. All right, so if you got exactly the same laptop, you know where to send it. You could send it to us. We're gonna fix it up. Just wanna add some here. So that this would be nicely done. Okay, so the goal is for me to fire up the hot air station, not hot air, the hot glue station, put some hot glue right there, and connect the battery, close the hinge, put the screws in, and everything should be fine. Alrighty, so everything is hot glued, everything is screwed in. I hope I put it in the right place. Let me take a look right now. Alright, so this one is not in the right place. This one should be right here. Alright, so somebody removed the SSD, maybe it was an SSD here. Maybe nobody removed anything. Hopefully nobody touched anything else, because then I'll have to take everything apart again. Close down just two screws right here. Like that. And like that. Lock this guy down there. And let's bring what we got here. I mean, this screw is not probably from here. All right. Now this screw is probably from right here. Okay. And that screw might be from here. And this one probably from right there. Yeah, no. No, yeah. Okay. Alrighty. Now let me remove the client's information from. Alright, the situation here is that they sent us a power supply, which it says, which is probably not gonna charge the battery. By the way, I don't remember if I connected the battery or not. Keep forgetting about that all the time. This one, even though it has the right tip, it might not charge the battery. Might be faulty as well, so let's take a look. Are we gonna get a light right here on the side? And we're not getting any lights probably because this is not the right power supply. Yeah, I mean, it's new, but it's not a Dell power supply. So let's see if it's even gonna power up. Here it's spinning. There's a Dell logo on the screen. And probably it's going to give us a message that this is not a Dell power supply. And we'll have to go find a Dell power supply. And this cable is extremely iffy. Oh, you know what? The light came on. The light came on right here. Seems like it's on. And it shows right there that the battery is out, meaning I forgot to connect the battery. All right, so let me shut it down and reconnect the battery. This is not even Windows operating system. Oh, strange. How do I shut it down? That's the question. Alrighty. Let's take this guy apart one more time. Can't believe I forgot to connect the battery cable, but it happens sometimes because it's the last thing you want to do. And sometimes you just get distracted on something here. Let's see what's that. No. Right here, you have to connect the battery. Well, we know that it works, right? We know that the jack is working because it was working without the battery in. So, here. Let's see. Forgot to mention that just people called me. So the battery charges now. The light is right here. I did power up and I did test it because, you know, I was on the phone. I couldn't really record and talk at the same time. So the laptop works fine. The battery charges. Thank you so much for watching. Oops. Information, point, information. Please leave a like, subscribe, and you guys take care and have a good day. Thanks.